Okay. Did I use half an hour or what did I use? Did I use too much time?
Too short a time, but we still got like 5 more minutes for questions.
Okay.
If you would like
I'm
to
sorry, I had promised him that I'll talk for 30 minutes and we'll have 10 minutes for question answer. I think I did a little bit over.
I think we have a couple of microphones. ¿Alguien tiene preguntas, señores?
If it's in English, I will understand.
Yes.
Thank you.
And your name first.
My name is Santiago. You talk about the importance of telecoms in every subject in our life, but you also talk about the importance of the way you privatize a company, a telecom company in any other countries around the world. You worked in the Telecom Commission back where you were the founder of the Telecom Commission in India, and you're probably aware of the lack of competition that we have here in the country, having one competitor having over 90% of the fixed lines and more than 70% of the mobile lines. So what would be your solution or your opinion on how to solve these competitive issues, or how to just try to get more competition in the country?
I think government will have to create, through regulatory mechanism, a level playing field, fair competition. Monopoly is not good for anybody, including for monopoly. Yeah. But you need that long-term vision. Okay. And only governments can dictate those things. It cannot happen overnight. You need to let other people participate and create an environment where there is real fair competition. One of the things I have noticed in Mexico is that the price per call or cost for per call is very high, comparatively. Okay. There's no reason for it. Okay. I think you want people to be able to use service in very many different ways, and that can only happen if the cost is lower. So I would leave it to the regulatory authority. Yes. But Mexico has done well in terms of, you know, number of telephones and all. Mexico has done pretty well.
Thank you, Sam. ¿Alguna otra pregunta por parte del auditorio? Sí, ahí está el micrófono.
I don't see you. Where are you? Mm-hmm. Ah, okay.
Thank you, Sam. I think you talked at some point that the learning model is going to change because of connectivity. Don't you think that there's a this change is going to be impersonal? That it's going to be difficult to have personal touch between teachers and students? If it is so, how do you think to address it?
Okay, I think we need to move on with new models. And we have moved on in the history. Every time there is a change, people resist change. Under all kinds of reasons, some good, some bad. There is no need to have that level of contact between teacher and student, perhaps. If we know that kids learn more from each other than from teacher, it is teacher's idea that more contact with student is good. It's not student's idea. I can assure you of that. There is a study done at Stanford 15 years ago, which said that students learn more when they interact with each other. That doesn't mean you don't need teacher. Today, teacher spends most of his or her time in creating content and delivering content. Content will be created on the net by experts, and delivery would be through multiple mechanisms using electronic media. So teacher's role will change to that of a mentor. Teacher will become a mentor and not teach. Tough for teachers to swallow. But it's going to happen. Believe me. Get ready for it. Okay. And this whole business of, you know, impersonal and taking human interaction away is all bogus. You have different kinds of interactions. I mean, in Japan, you have this Second Life. I don't know how many of you know about Second Life. It's called Avatar. Avatar is an Indian word. It says that I live my life in physical world, this life. But in virtual world, I could live another life, which is ideal that I didn't do it in real life. I want to act in a movie, I didn't do it in real life. Maybe in my virtual life I want to do that. So interaction with multiple lives is another whole new concept we never had before. You know, I have seen kids in Japan on the train feeding their pet on cell phone. I mean, serious business. Okay? I don't know how they do that, but I mean, these people are serious. There is something that they do that I don't understand. But must be important. I mean, if you take your cat and feed your cat and then feel good about it, there must be something. So lots of these things are happening. Okay. Yes.
¿Alguna otra pregunta, señores? Ahí arriba.
Good afternoon, Mr. Sam. I have a question regarding monopoly and regulation. And my question will be, how much in the regulation effort relies on technology and how much relies on a regulation entity? Because, for example, there are some alternative technologies like power line communications or next generation networks that will allow competitors to have access to the market. So how much relies on technology and how much on an institution?
I don't think there is a percentage. Okay. Technology is really an enabler. If you have cost-effective solution using power line carrier, which is equally good in quality, people will use it. If you have better solution using cable to deliver internet, people will use it. But on top of all of this, regulator has to be the key driver in growth. Regulator has to constantly watch, on one hand technology, on other hand cost, third hand competition, fourth hand customer service. Ultimate job of the regulator to me is to provide cheapest service with best quality to large number of people. That's the bottom line. How do you do that? So you juggle all these other things.
Okay, Sam.
Rafael knows that. So. Yes.
We thank you very much for this magnificent introduction.
Thanks,
to
everybody.
Technology. I was thinking that we're going to invite you to teach a course maybe next semester or the year after, to give us your view on technology, but not only for engineers, but for economists and for lawyers and all the different careers that are...
You know, when he called, he asked me, do you have slides? I said, no. And this afternoon, a gentleman came to pick me up at the airport, and I said, look, I don't even know what I'm going to talk about. I said, I'll just get up there. I know the subject. I'll get up there and see what comes to my mind. And I think it works most of the time. One last comment, since you mentioned technology. To me, technology is the greatest social leveler, second only to death. Thank you.
Thank you very much.